Welcome. Today's topic for discussion is signal, RSSI, noise, SNR, and EIRP. Signal. Signal, also known as RSSI, is the usable strength of the radio waves, expressed in decibels relative to a milliwatt between 0 dBm, strongest, and minus 120 dBm, weakest. Smaller negative numbers represent a cleaner, stronger signal. For wireless data communications, normal range is minus 45 dBm to minus 87 dBm. Anything below minus 85 dBm is generally unusable, and over minus 50 dBm can be considered perfect. RSSI, received signal strength indication, is measured in decibels from 0 to minus 120. Now when looking at this value, the closer to 0 the stronger the signal is, which means it's better. Typically voice networks require a minus 65 dB or better signal level, while a data network needs minus 80 dB or better. Normal range in a network would be minus 45 dB to minus 87 dB depending on power levels and design, since the signal is affected by the access point's transmit power and antenna as well as the client's antenna. RSSI factor. When RSSI is less than minus 90 dBm, the signal is extremely weak, at the edge of what a receiver can receive. When RSSI equals minus 67 dBm, the signal is fairly strong. When RSSI is greater than minus 55 dBm, the signal is very strong. When RSSI is greater than minus 30 dBm, your sniffer is sitting right next to the transmitter. Actual RSSI plus antenna gain equals displayed RSSI. Minus 68 dB plus 2 dB equals minus 66 dB. Note. RSSI values can be different depending on the chip vendor. Cisco can use range between 0 to minus 100, Atheros may use 0 to minus 127. Noise. Noise, dBm, in wireless communications is a combination of all unwanted interfering signal sources, such as crosstalk, radio frequency interference, distortion, etc. This value is measured in decibels from 0 to minus 120. The closer this value is to minus 120, the better, because that means there is little to no interference. Typical environments range between minus 100 dBm and minus 80 dBm. Signal to noise ratio, SNR. SNR is defined as the power ratio between a signal, meaningful information, and the background noise, unwanted signal. SNR equals signal by noise. SNR margin. SNR margin is sometimes abbreviated as simply SNR. SNR margin, dBm, also called as noise margin, is the ratio by which the signal exceeds the minimum acceptable amount, minimum SNR, to sustain a certain speed. It is normally measured in decibels. SNR margin is often confused and used interchangeably with SNR. Many DSL modems and wireless devices, notably DDWRT, open source router firmware, use SNR margin, only denoted as SNR. SNR margin is simply calculating the difference between signal, RSSI, and noise to get the SNR margin as a positive number expressed in dB. That is, SNR margin equals signal, dBm, minus noise, dBm. For example, if signal, RSSI, equals minus 55 dBm, and noise equals minus 85 dBm, then, minus 55 dBm signal, minus 85 dBm noise, equals 30 SNR margin. Higher SNR or SNR margin numbers represent cleaner signals, with less noise. Utilizing full 54 Mbps data rate, for example, requires at least 25 dBm of SNR margin. General rule of thumb is that, any SNR above 20 is good. Effective isotropic radiated power, EIRP. EIRP is the actual amount of signal leaving the antenna, and is a value measured in dB based on three things: transmit power in dB, cable loss in dB, and antenna gain in dBi. EIRP equals transmit power minus cable loss plus antenna gain. Example, we have an access point running at full power with a 6 dBi antenna on the 802.11a radio and a 2.5 dBi antenna on the 802.11bg radio. 802.11a EIRP equals 17 dB or 40 milliwatt minus 0 dB plus 6 dBi equals 23 dB equals 200 milliwatt of actual output power. 802.11bg EIRP equals 20 dB or 100 milliwatt minus 0 dB plus 2.5 dBi equals 22.5 dB equals 150 milliwatt of actual output power. Signal quality. Signal quality is a percent value between 0% and 100%, with the higher numbers representing better link quality. It is the percentage of the best theoretical ideal quality in regards to your local noise. It can be calculated differently, depending on the operating system or device used. It is based on signal strength and SNR margin. Generally, signal quality above 25 to 30% is usable. RSSI, DBM, relate to signal quality, percentage. Depending on your OS and application, Wi-Fi signal strength is represented either as quality in percentage, or an RSSI value in DBM, that is minus 70 dB. While there is no simple precise solution that is used universally, we will try to explain the approximate correlation between signal, RSSI, and quality, percentage. Generally, dBm greater than or equal to minus 50 dBm equals 100% quality. dBm less than or equal to minus 100 dBm equals 0% quality. For RSSI signal between minus 50 dBm and minus 100 dBm, quality equals dBm plus 100, multiplied by 2. RSSI equals percentage divided by 2, minus 100. For example, high quality, 90% equals minus 55 dBm. Medium quality, 50% equals minus 75 dBm. Low quality, 30% equals minus 85 dBm. Unusable quality, 8% equals minus 96 dBm. Free space path loss. Free space path loss is a measure of how much signal power you lose over a given distance. Typically you lose about 0.020 dB per foot in an outdoor or wide open office, doors, walls, glass, and etc. This is why as you walk away from an access point your signal gets weaker. Hope this video is helpful. Follow Leo's Tech Talk for WLAN or Wi-Fi videos in the below link.